Let's do this. Let's do this. Day 421. Make Songbringer. Today I'm working on the third playable character in the video game. This has always been promised for a long time. To be able to have Velle. She's the girl in this one cave. You eventually get to play as her in the game. So today I'm going to start working on that. What this is going to entail is I've already got some of the art started for her. So what this is going to entail is, first of all, getting it so the input works, so she can, you know, if she's being controlled via human, you can use your input, your buttons, your controllers, whatever you're using to control her. Or if she's AI, it needs to be an AI. So basically that might be the long part of making her, is writing the AI. But if I can figure out how to make the current behavior trees work flexibly enough, I think I can. Then maybe I can actually program her whole AI using behavior trees, kind of like how all the enemies and bosses do so far. Jib is this custom AI, completely written in code. There's no behavior trees. There's nothing scriptable about Jib's AI. So that's the thing. Is like, do I make a scriptable AI for Velle, or do I do the other things? So anyways, this live stream is just going to be kind of experimenting with Velle and seeing what works, what doesn't, and all that. So hopefully we'll see how far we get, but yeah. What's up, Pedro? How's it going, man? All right, so first thing, I'm going to create Velle. I had this done a while ago. I did something to create Velle. Okay, I'm gonna start with the const bool do Velle equals true. And then if we're doing Velle, we create the Velle entity. You went to the beach? Awesome weather? Right on. What's up, Marcane? Pedro, how far are you from the beach? Do you live near the beach? Is it easy to go to the beach, or is it like a hard thing to go to the beach? What's up, Henko? Oh, it's only 10 minutes away? Nice. Oh, that sounds easy. So you can be like, oh, I want to go to the beach, and you can just go there. That's cool. What's up? Welcome, new followers. Seth, Obsameth, Crazy Guy, Feared Killer. So we're creating Velle based on Velle's property sheet. Okay, she has render reflection. She needs a move for sure. She's got this attack type. It's been a minute since I've been here, that's for sure. But all these settings look about right. She's not gonna need HP 999999. But anyways, okay. So that should work to create her. And she does not need a gear component. She does need a name component. And that's easy to create with a name, actual name component like this now. Don't need to do this little line of code anymore. That's like 10 kilometers. All right, so she does need a health component. I don't even know why I'm really checking these things. I'm not sure if she needs a collision attack component. Maybe she does. Yeah, maybe she does. I don't know. if do Velle, we do this to create Velle, and then we return because we don't want to create Jib. If you have Velle, wait. Okay, so we need a better variable for doing. Let's get this all set up better. Whoops. So we need like a const bool do jib. So do jib is if we're not swordless and we're not doing Velle. And then we could use this instead of is swordless for creating jib. So if we are do jib here, and this is if not do jib. There, so that'll automatically remove jib if jib is already there. We'll see what we got. Now, Velle is not an optional character. She's actually a playable character that you will definitely encounter in the course of playing Songbringer. You don't play her until the very end of the game, the very last level. You get to play as Velle as the second player. So she's not exactly a central playable character, but she is a playable character. So it's something I promised in the Kickstarter, and I really want to get in there, and I think it'll really kind of give a nice thing to play as her as player two. If you're player two and you're Jib, you never really get to attack. But then as Velle, you can attack as player two. So it kind of changes your dynamic as player two. And I think it'll add a really fresh fresh thing to the game, especially at the very end of the game when you've had a good run playing as Jib for 9 dungeons. And then the 10th dungeon, you play as Velle if you're player two. Okay, so she does not have an attack opponent. I don't think we need an attack opponent. Let's just get her in there. I don't even know how many animations are still in here for her. Looks like it's still asserting. Jib's name component's not found. It's because Jib's not meant to be found. And do jib. The game's complaining. It's like, I don't want to let go, Jib. Oh, Jimmy! What's up, Zoc Games? How's it going? I'm doing good, man. Doing really good. Doing what I love. I'm happy to be doing it. I love who I'm doing it with, which is y'all. Cannot flux transition using a non-player id. Who initiated a flux? What? Hero ids dot front. That should be. Wait, what case we got? Player one id. One, player one, he had three. What's with that? What's with that? That's not right. Oh, I said player one. It's supposed to be player two. Duh. It is very good, isn't it? I love to do what I do. I'm so fortunate to be doing what I do. Oh no. Why not? She's running. Yeah, get it with your bad style. All right, look, she can move too. This is good. Oh yeah. Run around. Run around, Velle. So I think I have settings, so input player two is human or AI. Okay, so you can move her if you're AI or you're human. What's up, man? What's up, Rocket Bunny? Oh man, this is a great start. We already got this far. I was worried about input and stuff. I'm like, how am I gonna get her to move around? But this is, she already moves. That's great. Okay, so what do we need now? She's moved faster. That was like really slow. She's moved as fast as Rock does. Which is speed 111, Excel, Decel, Pathfind can push? I don't know. Maybe. Maybe she'd be able to push stuff. Oh, that sucks, Doc. I don't know if there is a word for that. Oh, man. Dang. Sorry to hear that. How good does a computer need to be to run Mac OS X? That's a good question, Rocket Bunny. I don't know. I'd say anything you bought from 2010 on is probably going to be it's good enough to run a Mac OS X at least. The latest versions of Mac OS X. You need to have an Intel processor and things like that. Are you talking about a Hackintosh or a Macintosh? All right, so now we need Velle, make her faster. Faster! Faster! Okay, I'm not gonna do push yet. Let's see if she's faster now. Oh, you wanna build a, you wanna make a Hackintosh? Sourdogs! What's up, Sourdogs? Oh, yeah. You probably do need specific hardware. Like I was just saying, you need to have at least an Intel processor or something like that. Okay, she needs a northward animation. I love this animation for her, it's so great. And what about her weapon? Does she have the weapon still? Her weapon's not working. She does have a weapon though. I don't know why it doesn't work. Okay, I'm gonna start drawing her running animations. Ahoy! Oh yeah, you gotta have all the right drivers and stuff. All right, Zoc. Heroes. Bell run. I have a run north. I must not have just done it yet. Here's her palm animate. Oh, let's get all these opened. Charge, charging, fall, floating, shoot, wake up. So run north. Did I just not do that yet? Maybe I just copied the east animation. Yeah, I think I did. This is her running east. Is her north. Okay. Should I do the weapon first? Maybe I should do the weapon next. Yeah, the weapon would be so clutch. Let's do the weapon first. She's got this shot type. Her attack type is shot, spawn upon bolt. Is there a command for running? Yeah, totally. Yeah, the new Windows Anniversary Edition has Bash Ubuntu Shell, or you can use Cygwin. Actually, I've tried out the Bash Windows Shell, and it's already, like, had... The first command I entered, it didn't work. I'm like, oh my god. I tried to make a symlink, and then I went into the symlink directory, and I was like, dude, it just won't even go to that directory, so... I don't know about the Bash Windows Shell. I don't think it works yet. Personally, it did not work for me. So I would at least use Cygwin for now if you're going to try and run SH files. There's also ways of doing it with the PowerShell thing. There's people that have really hacked out the PowerShell and made it super sick and awesome. So you can use the PowerShell too. But Cygwin's already tried and true. Cygwin's pretty awesome. Okay, I had it all working so she could use her palm bolt ability. It looks like I just don't have that ability maybe or something. What happens when it does this attack type shot spawn palm bolt? What does all that mean? Attack component can be initialized with data. Let's see if that works right there. The shot bang. Oh, and Rocket Bunny, Cygwin is spelled funny. Let me spell it for you. Data, get child, spawn, get stir. Does that work? Shot, pomble, it does work. Yeah, you're welcome. Oh, so it's just returning that it's empty because it doesn't have anything else besides. That. Or maybe we should just give it a mask. Like, maybe we should always have category mass, damage, delay, duration. Actually, yeah, we might as well just parse all these. And then Velle's property sheet. Can have attack type, mask, foe. What else can she hit? Static. No, not static, switch. Foe, switch, container. Maybe damage. Damage 0.5. Okay, category 2. Category shot foe. Shot friend. Is there anything else we might need for this attack? Mask, damage, delay, I guess. Delay and duration. Nah, we don't need those. Okay, so now when we create Velle, it shouldn't complain about the attack component being empty. Now I just gotta figure out how to use the palm bolt through Velle. Does she have? Why does she run it first? That's kind of funny. So neither of her attack functions work. Okay, so what am I gonna do to get her? I guess it would be attack system or input system. I guess I could put something in input system. Is that where? That's where we would use the sword, I think. So use button just checks your input cooldowns. Zilton, what's up? What are the advantages of a Unix shell compared to whatever Windows is? Oh my god, there are like a bajillion advantages to Unix shells compared to Windows' command.exe. Windows' command, all of Windows' underlying operating system is, man, I don't want to start a flame war, but being an engineer myself, it's subpar. Windows, MS-DOS, everything that Microsoft built, you know, is all subpar compared to Unix. And I know that's kind of a blanket statement, but it really is. If you've used Unix, really, PowerShell is pretty nice? Huh. I didn't know. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm just talking about old Windows. Maybe the new Windows is a lot better. Nice. So I'm trying to think of a way to get her to shoot her palm bolt, but using the existing systems. Oh yeah, Zilton. No, I'm not dogging Windows really. I'm just talking about the underlying operating system, the batch files, like the, you know, EXEs in general, DLLs. The freaking registry. Oh my god. That was a bad move, I thought. It's trade-offs. It's what you prefer, too. You prefer, you know, whatever you prefer is what you prefer. Is Xcode better than something like Visual Studio? Well, that's the same kind of question. It's trade-offs. What's up? Game shows is killing it today. Sucking up all my CPU. Meh. Okay, this is janky right here, but this might work. Use attack. If not attack, dot empty. Oh, whoops. I mean, if not E dot attack, dot empty. Your computer died for no reason? Doesn't see the hard drive? That's no good. Hard drive just unplugged itself. Yep, batch files. And you can run scripts. Like I was just telling you. So if the attack's not empty, and the e.attack.shot is not empty, then I know this is crazy, but I'm just gonna call it use palm. How about this? If attack shot is palm, use the palm. E.gear.ready. So she has to charge up her palm bolt. This might work. So this code's existing. This might work. Oh no, the BIOS. Is Linux worth it? You mean, is it worth the price of being free? It's a good question. Yes! Oh, her charge up works! But the let go doesn't work. Come on, shoot the beam, yo! Shoot it, girl! You got it. Shoot that thing. Why can't you shoot? Okay, let's figure that out. So using palm works. I guess I could make it an item. Yeah, I'll do that eventually. But what happened to her second half of this? She's supposed to charge. So she did the charge up, but then she never did the use. Let's check that out. Is Linux better than Windows? That's also a real trade-off. Yeah, I mean, you can't really answer that question very cleanly. Like Saladongs is saying. Come on. Okay, so she charges up and that works, but then I press it again and it doesn't even work. So something happened. So that, okay, we set the cooldown to 0.8 seconds. We clear directions, set her animation. She's got NM input locked and next input locked. Maybe that's it. You can make your own operating system? Cool. Yes, curved screen. You're like Steve Wozniak. You're like, I'm gonna make my own OS, my own little computer. You're channeling the Woz, dude. Channel the Woz. I guess, can you channel somebody that's still alive? That's probably not right. I don't know. I don't know my esoteric stuff. Yeah, so she cannot use her equipment once she's already got the button locked and stuff. Risk computers. Just think about it. Risk computers. Wait, no, Waz is not dead. He's alive. You saw Steve Wozniak at an airport? That's so cool. Did you say hi to him? He seems like a really approachable, smiley kind of guy. Yeah, we could channel Steve Jobs. You could channel Steve Jobs and like take your little Raspberry OS and make $1 billion on it. But you have to be really perfectionistic and like fire some people along the way. You have to get fired from your own position at your own company. But eventually you like are one of the most well-respected people ever in the computer industry. You left him alone. Didn't feel like bothering him. Yeah, I know what you mean. I would probably have done the same thing. I'm like, oh, look, it's Steve Wozniak, but I wouldn't have said anything. You have to remove Easter eggs from everything you made. You aren't successful if you haven't been fired from your own company. I like that. That's a good quote. That's a quote right there. Okay, so if I turned off has her the input lock. It should work now. I know, right? Yeah, that's the part you don't want to channel. Oh, really? Is that what happened? I didn't know that. What happened this time? I pressed the button, and this time it's like, Oh, Pumble is missing input component. Yeah, no saying for sure. He rejected a lot of treatments. Whoa. Yeah, it does seem like that, doesn't it? I mean, you gotta have like a, I think you gotta have like kind of like a mix between the two styles, like your Eastern medicine and your Western medicine. When it comes to things like cancer, like Eastern medicine can cure that, but only if you've done it, only if you've been on that preventative style treatment for a long time, But when it comes to the point where you already have cancer, like you kind of need Western medicine. But I don't know. I'm not a doctor. Pombolt. So it needs an input component for this Pombolt. She always run it first. I don't get that. Here we go. Yes, it worked. But it did some weird stuff to the whole screen. It's like, shoot. Oh, wait, there, it shot one that time. There we go. Shoot it. Yeah. Oh, because it's doing the screen effect thing. Lens sphere, here it is. We don't want to do lens sphere. Set ready sword? She doesn't have a sword. Ready, fire! Yes, ready, fire! Fire! Shoot stuff, yes! Choo, choo! Pachoo! 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 She can walk off the screen! Cannot flux transition using a non-player id. Cannot transition. What's up, Scissor? What's up? So, obviously, Velle needs... she needs a move. She cannot walk onto exits. Mask exit. And she cannot trigger. Cannot trigger an exit. What is it about Jib that makes him so he can't trigger exits? What is that? It's, no gravity. Category friend. I don't know. Could you become a mod? Sure. You could become a mod. How do I mod you? Mod, there you go. There you go, Rocket Bunny, you're a mod. I know, I'm doing that because I know you asked already. You asked a while ago. And then there was a lot of other people who were like, can I? But since you asked and there's no one else asking right now, you could become a mod for sure. There you go, you've been modded! Congratulations, Rocket Bunny, you are the mod! You're a mod now! Just don't abuse your power. Don't ban people unless they really deserve to be banned, alright? That's all I ask. But now you get a cool green sword next to your name, and you have unbelievable powers. What's up, Clock? Can you please not be a mod? Yes. I can't handle the pressure. Yes, you can not be a mod all you want. All you want, salad dongs. Man, if I could make you a pirate, I would. I'd be like, if there's like pirate button, like a real cool pirate, like a swashbuckling awesome pirate that says ahoy and means and like... and says R and stuff. But I mean, I wouldn't want to make you something you wouldn't want to be. Hooray for no responsibilities. Oh, this is such a good feeling, right? No responsibilities. That's a great feeling. Can he ban me because I asked? Yes. If you really want to be banned, we could ban you. But we're going to have to unban you if you want to be unbanned. That was weird. She shot the wrong way. Okay. Does that make her so she can't move onto the exits? This is the million-dollar question. Oh God, I keep on forgetting which button's what. Oh my God, I'm like freaking... There's up. Oh my God. Down. Oh, there. Okay. God. Okay, there. Now so you can't walk on the exits. Good, good. But what is it about Jib that makes it so he can't trigger exit components? I think there's something else that's kind of important. You don't even know how to ban anyone. That's cool. You don't have to learn. No one's forcing you to learn. What's Velle's story? She does have a cool story. She has a so Velle's backstory is that she was part of the Great War that took place on Xera thousands of years before this story takes place, Songbringer. So, basically on this very same planet, Xera, that Songbringer lands on, you know, in the current day or whatever the current day is in the plot of this game. That same planet thousands of years ago, there's a great war between all the Drob people. The Drob people are the ones with the goat masks and stuff, and the snake people, and a bunch of other like really crazy bosses and stuff. So Velle fought in this war. She's like a warrior, and she has all these sweet chi powers, where like she uses her courage and her chi energy and things like that to she has powers basically. So she has this charged up bolt thing she can shoot, and she also has a telekinesis palm item, which is an item where it's like a glove you wear and you can use telekinesis that way. And she had a mentor. She has a mentor named Monk Zumesh. Monk Zumesh is a character I might even introduce in Songbringer. I'm not sure, but I might just save it for another game. But anyways, so Velle fought in this war, and she did really well. She's an amazing warrior, but she got basically pummeled and shot down. And like basically the bosses or whatever won against her, and so they froze her in cryosleep. And so when you find her in that cave, in the cave on Xera, on Songbringer, whatever, in this game, Songbringer, she's been asleep for thousands of years inside cryosleep. And then the plot continues from there, and I don't want to like ruin too much or whatever what the plot is for Songbringer's part of Velle, whatever. So you'll find out more about her plot later on. Was that a good introduction to Velle's backstory, her story? Did I answer your question right? So it's like collision system. That's where you can trigger the flux slide. No, it's not. Step on exit. Yes? All right, cool. That might have been a little bit too much information, but basically she's a warrior. And she does have a backstory. I don't think there is anything that prevents Jib from actually triggering the flux slide. What is it that triggers the flux slide? Oh, it's the new exit. Oh, yeah. So you create an exit component with that. And this is definitely that then. Step on exit, K filter exit. So is that what it is in Jib's thing? Move. See, Jib has f.collision.category. Yeah. I'm still not figuring out what makes Jib not trigger the exit. Oh, I think it's just that you look at your own collision mask, and he doesn't have a collision mask for exit. Oh, okay, so that would make sense. Oh, and she does have it. Okay, so we want to not have her have the collision mask exit, but also so she can't walk on the exits either. Okay, so wait, if I take this out now, she should be able to walk over the exit, but she won't trigger it. Oh, okay, so I'm supposed to have my this finger on the M key. Yeah, she just walks right off. Ah, see ya later. Oh yeah, what's that? Okay, I'll see ya. Better. Okay, I'll see ya. I'm out. See ya. All right, I'm back. She can't trigger these either. She just walked through. She's stuck. Okay, good. All right, so yeah. So that was right. So she needs to have this exit component mask, but no mask there for exit. Does she have a sound for that yet? Kind of. Oh, and then once she charges it, she's not uncharged it. That's kind of cool. Okay, let's make it so she's not... She uncharges. GitHub's awesome. They made this framework allows you to run HTML, CSS, JavaScript natively instead of in a browser. Sweet. It's called Electron. Haven't heard of that. That's cool. So once we use the shot, we want to set e.gearReadyEye to be false. But she has to charge it up again. I think if she charges up, she's going to be able to move, and that's not going to be cool. M. Gosh, it's so hard to find the right key for this. Oh yeah, there's no charge. She needs some sweet sound effects. Oh, this is gonna be so easy to make some cool sound effects for her. Cause like I'm using Massive synthesizer and Massive is gonna be perfect for that. So if I charge up, oh, I could just make it so if she charges up and she's moving, she loses her charge. Or not. It's kind of cool if she can walk around. Okay, let's go somewhere else. Nice. Velle walked pretty nicely there. Let's go find some enemies, Velle. Come on. She's like, yeah, come on. I'm going. It's hard to hit these guys. Why isn't it working? This is really, really hard. You know what? I am gonna change my controls. So I've got an Xbox controller here. Make sure this Xbox One controller. M scripting, yeah. Oh, I know, right? Take C++ to JavaScript? Yeah, that blows my mind too. Totally. Once I found out about that, I was like, really? 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 Xbox One, wired controller. I want this to all be player one, player two, which is Yeah, so this is, change all these to 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. It should make it so I can control the player one with the keyboard and Velle with this extra controller. Yes, it works. Sweet. Some of the stuff they're doing is really clever, yeah? Okay, now we need to go find some enemies because I'm ready to rock it now that I got this controller. Okay, so her shot does not work. And maybe this is not as fun when you have to charge it up. It kind of would be cool if you charge, if you charged it up, you just hold down the button and then let go. Maybe you can like, yeah, it would be cool if you could like, if you just let go and then it would fire. Okay, so it's not doing anything. Why is it not hurting enemies? And the memory is an array of zeros? Whoa. Oh, it's a crazy hack job, really. Oh, they get around the whole memory management by basically creating a big pool of memory and then acting as an allocator for when you call malloc. Oh. Whoa. What's up, Aerodith? Hello, welcome to the stream. How is it to program for 20 years? Is it boring programming now? No way, dude. No way. No, I've been programming for 22 years now, and it's always been a passion of mine. It was my passion before I made art and stuff like that, you know? Like, programming's always been one of my passions. I would say if programming is a passion for you now, then it probably always will be. But the thing is, you have to be doing it in a passionate way, you know? Like, I can see, I did do some programming for a while that was business software, and it was boring as fuck. I hated it. I hated it. I hated making business software. It was so boring. So that's what I'm saying. If you do a project that interests you, if you're using your skills for things that you're passionate about and that are fun for you and that are exciting for you, you're probably never going to be bored with it. But if you do stuff just for the money, if you just focus on business, if you're doing things that you're not passionate about because you think you have to do them that way or something, you're probably going to get bored with anything you try. Maybe her hair should shake more. Yeah, I'll work on that. Okay. Use palm. Oh, right. The palm bolt wasn't hurting anything. Why is that? It says category shot friend mask. Oh, it needs some damage, that's for sure. Let's try that. Yeah, you're thinking of studying programming? Yeah, you're definitely gonna have to learn a few things about it. Try it out, man. See if it's your kind of thing. If you like it, if it's your passion, then cool. It probably will be. What? Okay, so she can hit the bushes? Yes. Pick up the diamond. Oh, it doesn't let me pick up the diamond. Entity without a gear component is trying to pick up an item. Okay, Velle should be able to pick up items. So yeah, if you have a gear empty and you have the category friend, you don't have to have the name Jib. So So yeah, Velle can pick up items. We need some enemies that are kind of easy to hit. These little red guys are hard to hit with a projectile. Let's go find an area with that. Yes, let's walk on the water. It's Jesus, Velle. Go forth and sin no more, my children. Red guys everywhere. I don't want to fight these red guys. I want to fight some guys that are easy to hurt. And why are they? Every single screen's a red guy. Need some more enemy types for the overworld, that's for sure. Dude, red guy. All I've run into is red guys so far. Here we go. Here's some blobs. You started C++? Okay, whatever. We're just going to fight some red guys anyway. You learned a few things, but it's kind of difficult. It is kind of difficult. Saladongs? Yeah, I highly agree with Saladongs' advice. Learn C first, man. C is simpler, easier, and will teach you more of the basics. Yep. Yeah, totally. So, Caesars, were you saying you love my set of dev tools or somebody else's? Yeah, Aerodith, there's also Learn C the Hard Way. It's a free book. Oh yeah, Saladongs. Which one are you recommending, Saladongs? Oh, the God mode. Yeah, the God mode helps so much. Programming language, Brian Kernighan. Cool. There's also this one. I've heard this one's good. Learn C the Hard Way. And that's, you know, that's sarcasm, by the way. What the hell? Why does it like lose the link sometimes? It is? Nice. The book that I learned from no longer exists. I learned like in 1994. Let me check this one out. The C programming language. Well, that's a pretty good name. Good title. Whoa, you can rent it. Look, you can rent this book. Dang. That's kind of expensive, but how many pages is this? Oh, it's only 272 pages. Oh, cool. It's a nice quick read. Yeah, but I look like I'm 26. Thanks, man. Thank you. But if you get really close, you can see that I definitely have tons of wrinkles. And I got white hairs in my beard. There's just one white hair. I'm sure you can't see that on the freaking tiny window, but like, I'm older than I look. Okay, let's see. So now I've got some damage set on her palm bolt. Let's see if that actually works. Yeah, having the foundation of C is really helpful no matter what language you're programming in, too. C is an amazingly good foundational language. Oh, it does work. Yay! Nice, that's cool. Okay, that's great. Now that she can like attack enemies and stuff. Her other ability is gonna be, I think, a heal. So I don't know why any one of her buttons works though. That's gotta work on that. Least 5 years. Thanks, man. Yeah. No, I'm 36 now. 36. 36 sounds right. I think I'm 36. Yeah, learning the logic of programming, totally. Yeah. Yeah, Visual Studio SC. Yes, it does. Learning any kind of pro, yeah, you're right, totally. Python is also a great language to learn, I think, at first. It's kind of like C, but it's more forgiving. But you're not really going to learn some of the more important things like pointers with Python. Yeah, you do. Yeah, Saladongs bring an excellent point there. You're forced to learn how memory works with C because it's a little lower level than some of the other languages out there. So you're forced to understand what a pointer is. A pointer is a very simple thing. It's just the memory address of another variable. Very, very simple concept. But like it tricks a lot of people because they're like, oh my God, pointers are hard. But don't go into it thinking that pointers aren't hard because they're not. All right, so what it needs next is the proper system. Because I don't want to give her an equipment component. But I do want her to be able to have multiple items that she can use. She has two items she can use, her palm and then either her heal. I'm pretty sure it's going to be a heal ability. Yeah, C does have some pretty good quality to it. So in the input system, right now, I've kind of hacked something in here so that she can. Think I'm just going to think about it for a minute and do her north running animation. All right, Belle. So, first step here, I want to make it so she has her first frame. I'm also going to open up rocks running north frames because that's kind of, that might help guide me a little bit. Remember how I did that animation? So run or running north. Yeah, I know. I can't wait for Jai. I hope it is too. What's wrong with the semi? I think that's pretty damn difficult. Yes. Yeah, Aerodith, it is. It is. Assembly is a lot. It's a lot lower level than any other programming language, it seems like. But it's not as low level as writing in pure machine code. So at least assembly's got that going for it. But yeah, don't worry about assembly. Don't worry about learning assembly, especially at first. If you're just in the point where you're like, maybe I should learn C or some kind of C-based language or whatever, stay there. Don't worry about assembly until years later, maybe. Yeah, Ruby's cool. There's a lot of great programming languages out there, it's true. And there's a lot of languages that have tried to replace C, but they really haven't ever succeeded. This frame's kind of weird right there. But anyways, okay, so he starts off with that. He lifts up his front leg a little bit, and then he jumps into the air. Swaps, lands. He's got this leftward pixel shift, which kind of gives him this loping feeling to his run. Okay, let's turn her around. Get my graphics tablet plugged in. What's up, Pete and Wally? What's up, man? He does. Salad Dongs is an excellent programmer. You should definitely listen to his advice. I say that without even ever looking at any of Salad Dongs' code. But we've talked a lot about code over the months, and I think I got a pretty good feeling that he's a great programmer. I do have a backwards facing pose already. These are her charge poses. We don't need these in this animation at all. You're getting your app out soon? Sweet. Yeah, I know, right? I look back on that time in my life learning how to program, and I smile. I love that time. Yeah. Your app's coming out too? What are you making, Scissor? And you're making an educational app for teaching kids about proton therapy. Oh, I think you said that one time. I think you mentioned that a while ago on one of the streams. All right, ready to start this animation out. Actually, I want to make this even easier on myself. I'm going to start with rocks running animation. Let's go to Velle's. Close it. Save this one as Velle Run North Replace. Thank you very much. Thank you. Oh, mobile game? An idle clicker game genre? Sweet. Yeah, definitely link your games and your apps and everything you guys are making when you come. I'd love to check out what you're making, and I'd love to help promote it and whatever I can do. What's the best simple, fast language for making a game, in your opinion? It totally depends on the game you're making. It depends on the scope of your game. If you want to make a quick game that you want to do in a weekend, then I would use Game Maker or something like that. I would never do that. I would never make a game in just a weekend. But like if that's what you want to do, then yeah, I would use like something like Game Maker. But if you wanted to do something that's like more like a month-long project, then it would totally depend on what kind of platform you want to release it on. So if you want to release your game on the web, you know, you'd probably want to use JavaScript or something like that to write your game. If you want to release it on Steam, then you'd probably want to use C or C++ or Unity or something like that. It totally depends. Totally depends. Nice. You got a recent stream? Sweet. Yes, yeah, Java and Python are a little slower. Yeah. You wouldn't have made it without the Songbringer vids? Cool. So she's gonna have her left elbow back. And so it's back. Is that back enough? It's probably not back enough. Her right arm is forward. It's gonna be a little darker, tiny bit darker. So she has her left leg forward, her right butt cheek's gonna be a little, might squish to the left a little, I'm not sure. What's up, Protito? Yo! How many years is needed for you to build a game with pretty good quality? If you have a team of 5 programmers, it would be easier, right? But not impossible? Oh, man, that's also really, really depends. Really, really depends. It depends on your game you want to make. It depends on the scope of your video game. It depends on the team of 5 programmers that you're talking about. Gosh, that's kind of an almost impossible question to answer. All I can tell you is how fast I can write a game alone. That's all I really know. So, if you want to help, if you could rephrase the question or whatever, I could try and answer it better. Give me some more specifics. I think her right, it's gonna be more like that. So she's got her right arm forward. It kind of looks like forward, yeah. It's pretty good. It's pretty good for a first frame. The trickiest part about these run animations is like getting them down the first time. So it's really good to have this example of rock to start with, right there. Totally, right? There are. CC0? I don't know. I don't know this Creative Commons things perfectly. How much time for a MOBA game? Just by yourself? It's crazy you asked that, because the last video game I wrote was a MOBA. And so I know exactly how long a MOBA would take. Now that I'm an artist, I could do the art part myself. So the MOBA part of the programming part of the programming part of writing a good MOBA game took about 2 years, full time. That's like, you know, 6 days a week, long hours, 2 years. That's my programming efforts. That's what I know for sure. And I know I could probably create the art for something like that in, you know, another year's worth of time. So maybe 3 to 4 years to write a good MOBA. The difficult part about writing a MOBA is that you're creating multiplayer, and multiplayer is hard as shit. It is really hard to, I'm talking about real-time multiplayer. Real-time multiplayer is a very difficult genre to get into because there's, no matter what you ever do, your input is always going to be at least 200 milliseconds behind what the player actually feels. So that's the biggest wizardly tricks you got to pull out of your sleeve. Is tricking the player into thinking that their input is not delayed by 200 to 400 milliseconds. And then you've got all these other problems to deal with real-time multiplayer, like keeping players in sync. What happens if one person's set of the game runs their instructions just very slightly differently? We're talking about a floating point value being off by 0.00001 that completely changes everything that the other player experiences versus the other player. So you have to stick to mostly integer values if you want to use stuff that's consistent always. You can't use floating point because floating point is different on every platform a little bit, just barely, you know, just barely different. So but that barely difference, when you add it up over time, it's crazy. So anyways, multiplayer is hard. That's all I'm trying to say. You made League of Legends? Basically, yes, we tried to make League of Legends for iPhone with crazy cartoon zany characters. The game's called Hero Bash, and it didn't do well financially. Is my site still down? Oh, my site's still down. I'm not sure what happened to my website. Dang, is it on the App Store? I think you can find it on the App Store. Yeah, if you just type in Hero Bash, you can see what kind of game this is. But yeah, we worked a long, long time. Me and my buddy, we worked to make that game. It took 2 years, and we basically had a very, very bad marketing plan because we didn't do any. That was our marketing plan. Our marketing plan was to keep everything secret until the game's launch, and I realized how much of a mistake that was at launch. I really don't think you should keep your game secret if you're an indie. It's a bad idea. Sometimes, like, AAA companies can keep their games secret for a long time, but even today, AAA teams are realizing that they have to also publish and start promoting their game months and years before they create it. So my advice is, if you're an indie, you should be sharing anything, everything about your video game that you're making from day one. From when you have a single pixel on the screen, go share a screenshot with that, and you'll find the people that are interested in what you're making, and they will come. You know, it's just like, if you build it, they will come. It's a field of dreams. That's it. It's a field of dreams. Yeah, I know. Yep. Yeah. That's me in the trailer. My friends. Okay, so we got frame one done. Frame one, looking good. All right, so we need frame two now. Okay, something like this. No, like that. No. Nope, yep. This is where her chest starts to go changing to the side a bit, so actually I should have just started like, this. But he's got his right. Oh yes, yeah, so this works. His right, her right shoulder's back. It's not bad. It's not bad for a frame too. Yeah, it was a complete flop. I mean, not a complete flop. Like, but yeah, financially, yes, complete flop. We made about $20 a month on that video game. And I think to this day it still makes $20 a month, which is about what it costs for the server. So, and we also spent $5,000 trying to promote it. So that was that. Like I was saying, our mistake was we didn't try and do any kind of marketing on it. So, at the launch of our game, that was like when we finally even announced it. That's the first time we ever even shared a screenshot was on day one of trying to put it on the App Store. And so we spent $5,000 on this PR company, and the PR company got some of the worst results I'd ever seen. Like, I was so mad. I was so pissed off that I just spent $5,000 and literally nothing happened. Not a single review got written about our game from us spending, and $5,000 was a lot of money to me. At that time, it still is a lot of money to me. You know, it's like, dang, you don't want to just drop $5,000 every day. So for the company to not get any reviews written, and it's just, they just did a horrible job. But like, I learned my lesson. I learned my lesson that you have to do your own kind of marketing. If you're an indie, at least you have to do some marketing. And that's so really, I have a lot to thank for that game. Hero Bash taught me so many great lessons on like, how to do things yourself as an indie, especially marketing wise. If I hadn't have learned that lesson the hard way, I probably would not have ever started Songbringer. So, and I definitely wouldn't have started live streaming Songbringer. I wouldn't have shared screenshots on Twitter of Songbringer from the first beginning of it all. So I have a lot to thank for that video game. And but if anybody's interested, I did write a whole article about this too. There's a Gama Sutra article about it. So what's up, T? What's up? Welcome, Teek. I'm working on another player two character for you and for everybody else that's player two. Velle's in the game now. Check it out. Velle's already in the game, kind of starting on her today. Hold on. Yeah, so and what's cool about, so you're gonna play as Velle for one level at the very end, and when you're going up the tower, you get to play as Velle, so you'll finally be able to have an you finally be able to have an attack. You know, as Jib, you don't really have an attack, but as Velle, you do. You have this palm bolt thing. So that's pretty cool. So I'm just working on her art right now. With art and other little basics. Okay, so frame one, she should have that pixel there. Like that. Yes, so Hadouken, right? Hadouken! This is off to a good start. All right, so let's do frame three. Shall we do a frame three, shall we? Yes? What the hell is going on here? Good. All right, so this is where her legs just swap. Sort of. So this leg's gonna be coming forward. So this leg's gonna have more. Well, now she's all bow-legged. That doesn't work. That's not working either. That's not working either. Man. Tough to get this just right. I guess that's gonna have to do. Yeah, okay, that'll do. That'll do. That'll do her. And then, so this leg is coming back more, so it's gonna be more well-lit. And a little longer looking. Same thing, I don't want to give it too much of a bowed look. It's funny the difference that one pixel can make in pixel art. I'm purposely not touching her hair at first. Because I want to get the core bit of the animation done first with her arms and legs and body moving right, and then I'll get her hair to kind of bounce a little bit too. Let's do this. Throw the baby off the roof. Let's do this. Let's do. Oh, you're talking about let's do this. Oh. Let's. Okay, let's do this. Let's do this. Think of Bob's Burgers when I say let's do this. This one part in the show where Bob goes, let's do this. It's really funny. Whoa, yeah, we're doing this. And then he break a cage. And then he get this. He got this. No inter... What? So this leg's back. No. Yep. So there's a little bit of jerkiness in the animation where somewhere in the middle there, it's like it jumps a bit too many pixels at once. So she jumps up to the left there a little bit, and then she kind of goes back to the middle, and then she jumps a little to the right. Oh, there, that's the frame. That frame right there is like too much bounce to the right. Yes, please, post links. Yes, please, post your links. Always. Really glitchy? Cool. Nice, man. Now that is still, she's still kind of bouncing a little bit too much to the left. I think it might be this frame. Yeah, there, that's better. She already has like a cool, a good like little sway going on when she runs, so that's pretty cool. Okay, now the hair. So starting out, her hair is gonna be kind of like centered, and then as she bounces, this is where she's like bouncing. Her hair is gonna flop to the right a little bit. Your wind event trigger did not work? Oh, well, that's a good bug find. Whoops, is that whoops like the wrong link or something? Oh, whoops like the bug. Damn. Let me save that link. I'll check that out later. I would play it now, but my videos get flagged by YouTube as copyright infringement if I do, so I can't. Can't play music. Unless I stopped uploading to YouTube. That's probably not gonna happen. Too many people on YouTube love these videos, I think. I think so, man. So yeah, hair flopping to the right, hair gets back in the middle, hair flops to the left. Boing. Bouncy, bouncy, boing. That's just too predictable. A little bit too predictable for sure. Duh, it's good playtester for sure. Heck yeah, more bugs you find like that's bet. It's awesome. Wait, what happened there? Oh, this is a double up frame. Maybe this frame. Should only bounce like that much. And this frame, it should only bounce this much. It kind of works. It looks like she's got a little worm on top of her head, but it kind of works. I kind of like it. Yes, it does. It goes public on the 17th. That's great. Ah, it's so great, man. Did you have the link to it yet? Is it up yet, or is it like it's like private still? All right, let's throw this animation in there. Oh, thanks, man. Thank you. Appreciate that. Oh, yeah, that's right. itch.io. .found. Oh, yeah, with your new Greenlight campaign. That's right. Cool. Oh, the site's still private. Okay, so it's going to be up at that location. All right, let me check. I'll take down this link right now so I got it. This is good. This is good to get this, get her AI. I mean, not her AI, but like just the basic functionalities of Velle being a human played character is really easy. The more time consuming part is going to be creating an AI for her that will work decently well, but that can come next. First, just the basics. Second, we'll do the more advanced things like that. So today I'll probably just focus on the basics of Velle, and tomorrow I'll start on her AI. Oh, north animation doesn't work. Oh, did I forget to hook it up? That's probably what I did. Run, we need run north, not just east. The little worm on top of her head. It looks so funny. And she needs to pop more. She's not bouncing up in the air enough. Even though that's like 3 pixel jump there, she's walking north. So she needs to like go at least one more pixel. Here too. Maybe this one too. Maybe this one she moves another pixel up. Do the worm. Do it. Do the worm. Man, this is one of those days where a game show just decided to start eating up 150% of the CPU right when it started. So my computer fan's been going the whole time. Bugs the hell out of me. Sometimes game show just gets in this little Error zone. It's trying to record my screen. It usually uses like 40% of the CPU. That's a little bit better. She definitely looks more hoppy, she's like bouncing a little more. The only thing is her legs don't ever come in. They need to come inward a little bit. Especially if her leg is forward. I don't know, it looks weird though. At least that frame. What's up, Fantiun? Thank you, man. I appreciate you saying that. That looks okay with that leg like that. And then let's try this leg move back. And then maybe this one too. Okay, and that's good too. What? Something's now looking really wrong. Oh, there, it's looking a little better now. Okay, let's try that. Is Bob Fu here? He was here a little while ago. How much will it cost? It's going to cost $16. Yeah, Bob Fu, he was here. He was here earlier. He's gone now. He's taking a break. He's kicking it back. He died doing what he liked to do. He did. He lived an amazing life. He died doing what he loves. Yeah, that's better. Now her legs look a little less bow-legged when she's running north. Yeah. Yeah. Check out your sexy reflection. That's right, yeah. Yeah. Check it out, everybody. Alright, we got a new animation done. Ba-boom. Check that in. Okay, this isn't ready to be checked in, except for the raw part. Git commit raw. Okay, so I got maybe a few more minutes in today's stream, so I'm going to start on her south animation. It should be pretty simple. I think I could just copy her north running animation pretty much and put her face on there. That's kind of how simple it is. Oops, already got that one open. I think it's just a copy of East. Oh, wait, no, I did do this already? I started this. Oh, shoot. Got one. Oh, these are almost exactly the same frame. I like how much she's like reaching though. It's pretty cool. All right, Rocket Bunny, see ya, man. All right, so in this frame, I started the other way with her putting her right arm forward. So I might as well flip this over horizontally. So this is her, should be her right leg, her right arm is forward. Her right leg is back, okay. So that leg's back, which means, yeah, okay, so I guess we'll keep it like that, and then this leg's forward, so it should appear a little brighter. Okay, that's pretty good for frame one. How do you host the stream? I don't know. Is there like a host button somewhere? So her hair is going to move like, wait, no, she swapped her arm in this photo, or in this one, I think her arm is flipped over. No propagate frame one. Yeah, this is where her, I know her chest flips over, so. Let's make this one actually flip over completely. So her right arm's back, her left arm's forward, her right leg is back. Wait, no, her left leg is forward. Her right leg is back. Wait a minute. This is confusing me. Thanks, Pete and Wally. Thank you. Oh, right. Okay, so I did flip it over. Okay, so yeah, exact opposite leg. This is kind of a big jump from that frame to that frame, so I might have to make this sort of an intermediary frame. But I'll do that once I'm refining the animation. Once again, we have left arm back. Wait, no, right arm back. Yeah, right arm back. And this is right leg forward. Run animations, they're tricky at first, but then once you get them down, you're like, yes! That's it. That's how you do it. So she's got her right arm back still. And her right leg. Right leg is still forward. Okay. And that's good. That's it. That's all I needed to change there. All right. I think this is where she finally changes, because her right arm did you use we use Coco's 2DX for Hero Bash as well. That was kind of the old days of Coco's 2DX. That was their 2.0 series. The 3.0 series has got a lot of improvements, which are really awesome. But a lot of also kind of unnecessary features in the 3.0 to Coco's 2DX. Depending on your project, of course. Our project is 2D. This game's 2D as well, Songbringer, so we don't need any of the 3D stuff they started adding. This one is right arm forward, so yeah, this needs to flip over.
And this is right leg back. Right leg back. Which is, oh, it's already how it is. This is on the inside. This is on the outside. They are, yeah. Right? It's like, I don't know. I kind of think they don't need those things, but probably a lot of people do need those things. So, you know, I'm probably an edge case for how I prefer to develop games. But nonetheless, I'm very thankful to the whole Cocos 2DX team. They've done an amazing job. They put out like a literally an amazing product. Cocos 2DX is awesome. It's huge. There's so much source code in it now. Not that more source code is a better thing, but seriously, the core parts of it are pretty good. I'm happy to be using it. Although I do wish there was like a minimal version. I kind of wish there was like a minimal version of Cocos 2DX. You know, they just kind of got rid of all the things you don't normally need, like 3D and all that. What's up, Pokey Brothers? Welcome. Welcome to the stream. Yeah, it is. Yeah, it's really big over there, huh? Lots of books are written about it. I know there's like a Korean book, a Chinese book already about it. There's a few English books too. All right, last frame. So once again, this is right arm forward. This is right leg back. Good, that's all I needed. Shoot, that was a really easy frame. That's it, that's all there is to it. All right, let's see how this goes. Cross your fingers. Coco's scene graph was really bad. Oh yeah, it might be. I don't use it personally, so maybe it is. Yeah, I have used it in the past, and I thought it's pretty good. I thought the scene graph is really neat because you can do all these. You can do really cool custom animations between. You can literally customize anything about their scene graph. But I just don't use it because my game is not really the kind of thing that has a lot of scenes. It's really only one scene. Yeah, I don't know that much about it either, really. That's not bad. That's kind of lucky that even turned out that good on the first try. I'm amazed actually that it's working that good on the first try. Wow. Okay, well, let me get rid of the other frames I don't need now. Like this one, this one, this one, this one, this one, and this one. Make sure this is still working. Yeah, good. Okay. Let's see this in the game. Yeah, Java Live GDX. Mm-hmm. Right, yeah, Pete and Wally, yeah, that's cool. Mm-hmm. No, Salad Dogs is really writing a cool game engine, though. From scratch, from the ground up, he's like, literally, he even tried to, like, hack into Mac lower level APIs that are undocumented to make it awesomer. Saladong's is doing a kick-ass job making his engine. Yay!
Yay! We have all four running animations. She's bouncing maybe a little too much going south, though. She, like, looks a little bit too jaunty. Like, yay! Whoopee! Just a little bit too much. Like, right there, she jumps up in the air. How many pixels? Four? Four whole pixels. Yeah, let's bring that down. One pixel, at least. One. Here, let's do all these. One there. That one's down. This one goes down one. This one goes down one. And all of these should not have propagate frame one. Okay, it's better. I'm still convinced that Coco Run Loop can be avoided, but it's not worth the amount of effort it would take, right? Yeah. Gotta give in on some things. I know how that must feel. I just noticed that I thought I had transparency disabled, but I could still see through my Mac window into the window behind it. Okay, it's looking a lot better, but now the one last change I'll make is to make it so her arms kind of swing out a bunch when she's going south, and they don't really swing out that much going north. I think it's doing a little bit too much arm swinging. But I want to check in so far. You figure out how to work around it? Yeah. You've never had a major problem with it? Yeah, nice. I don't think I have really either. The biggest problem I had was that I couldn't use custom uniforms without incurring like a whole bunch more getting draw calls. But I finally found a workaround for that. And then they finally announced that they're going to be fixing it in the latest Coco Studio X. So, oh well. At least, I mean, I already got a solution now that works pretty well. So, okay, I'm going to do one last change to this animation, just make it so she doesn't quite swing her arms so much. Maybe she can swing her arm for that one pixel there, or one frame. Oh no, that looks weird. Definitely not. Sounds more like it's Android's fault. I know, getting the Android NDK set up is... If it's your first time setting it up, it's definitely like, oh my god, really? But then you figure it out, and you're like, okay, I kind of got the process down, and... Yeah, Android development in general is kind of like that. I think. I don't know, maybe it's just the NDK part of it that's hard. Alright, so this is going to be it for today's stream. I'm going to run it one last time and check out how she looks running south. And
Yeah, tonight I'll work on some more of these little basic things with getting Velle to be basically playable as a human player. And then tomorrow I'll start back to I'll start on her AI. Yeah, so peace, everybody. Thanks for watching. And I hope you all have a great night. Let's see how this looks one last time. Oh, she still swings her shoulders a bit too much. But I can touch that up in the next time I do a little pass on this animation. So yeah, peace everybody. Have a good night. See you later.